At the University of Tennessee, civil engineering assistant professor Chris Cherry collaborated with the Biosystems Engineering Department to create the nation's first automated e-bike sharing system. With two bicycle stations now on campus, the pilot program offers an opportunity for healthy active transport while reducing emissions.
One of the main motivations for including electric bikes in a bike sharing system is I was hoping to expose more people to a relatively very efficient mode of transportation. A lot of people won't bicycle around campus or around East Tennessee because of the terrain and the weather and other things. Electric bikes can help overcome that. I worked with Stacy Worley in Biosystems Engineering and the Civil Engineering Department and collaborated on developing a station, a prototype really, of how to share electric bikes and how to study the way people use electric bikes as a research experiment. And we put together a system that helped deal with how to manage battery charging and battery exchange and came out with a pretty successful first attempt.
Well, I think we had some really good brainstorming sessions and the concept was born. We drew from some of the systems that were out there already and we kind of dialed in on the expense of the bike and how that was a major factor in making it well suited to a sharing type of system. Then we came up with the idea of our battery vending and management system to make the most use of the bike, where we have more batteries than we have bikes, so that there's always a charged battery for the users whenever they come to pick up the bike and they get maximum range out of it.
Basically, anyone with any student, faculty, or staff at the university can sign up to participate. And at this point, it's completely a research project, so it's entirely free. And they sign up through us, through our website, and then basically we put them in the system. And as soon as they're in the system, they can swipe their card and take a bike. As soon as they swipe their card, we know who it was and what bike they got, what battery they took. As soon as you pull the bike out, we're collecting GPS data. You use that to study your behavior. I'm using it to study your physical health. It's a great option for transportation.
From the initial concept and design to the rigorous labor schedule needed for completion, the success of the on-campus e-bike system is a result of collaborative efforts.
We had several groups of people participate in this project. We have electrical engineering students, we have staff and faculty from biosystems engineering and civil engineering, myself and my students.
Everything was basically built in-house. So the structure is built across campus in the civil shop, all the electronics, the software, everything inside the structure is designed and built at the biosystem shop.
The beautiful part of a university is you have a universal body of knowledge and experts in almost any field, and you can piece together these collaborations in a meaningful way.
Well, my supervisor here made a statement that's really stuck with me. He said the really interesting and powerful things happen at the intersection between the different areas that can be brought to bear on a problem. And it's really special when you get the right mix of people together with just the right assorted skill sets to attack a problem, and it just fills all the holes that there are. And in the end, you always wind up with a very high quality project that turns out to be more than you ever initially thought it could be.